Hey friends, I'm Pastor Joe. Today is Tuesday, and I have your word for the day. Whether I was a student in elementary school, middle school, high school, college, or in seminary, I had a common feeling when it came to taking tests. I dreaded test day, but at the same time, I liked the challenge of the test. I never wanted to fail the test. I wanted to beat the test, but I hated taking the test, and I was always relieved when the test was over. I always knew whether or not I did well based on how fast I finished. If I was one of the first ones finishing the test, I knew I did pretty well. If I was one of the last ones to finish the test, well, it normally wasn't good. During finals week in college and in seminary, after my last exam was taken, I would walk out of the door, lift my hands, and shout, "Woohoo!" If you have faith as a follower of Jesus, did you know that your faith is being tested on a regular basis? Listen to the words of James from James chapter 1, verses 2 and 4. "Dear brothers and sisters, when troubles come your way, consider it an opportunity for great joy. For you know that when your faith is tested, your endurance has a chance to grow. So let it grow, for when your endurance is fully developed, you will be perfect and complete, needing nothing." Hard times are going to happen. Troubles are going to come your way. And when troubles and hard times come your way as a follower of Jesus, we are not supposed to throw up our hands in despair. We are not supposed to give up. In fact, when you are faced with stuff of life that tempts you to find a dark corner and hide, remember, this is a test. And you want to pass this test so your endurance can grow and help you to become a perfect and complete person. And I have a little advice. When you're faced with a season of testing, invite others in. If you can't be transparent with everybody, be transparent with somebody. Invite them into your dark corner and ask them to pray with you and pray for you during that season of testing. And I do have good news for you. Testing does not last forever. Keep living by faith. Keep putting one foot in front of the other. And one day soon, you too will be able to lift your hands in victory, shout "Woohoo!" and say, "Praise God, my faith endured, and God has carried me through it all." If today's word for the day has blessed you, like it or leave a comment. God bless.